I'm not sure if the match was decided on the back of Dhoni's decision. Recently, Calcutta has been a pretty good chasing ground. The outfield is pretty fast and the ground was not very big. The boundaries were not very big. So the chasing was not the worst call to make. The problem was that his bowler didn't bowl well enough. And when you end up conceding 202 runs, then it becomes really difficult, especially in the final. Common sense might suggest that you put runs on the board and put scoreboard pressure on the opposition, but Dhoni surely knows what he was doing, so I don't think the pitch had any part or the toss had any part to do with the final result, except that Mumbai were too good on the day and Chennai really were way off the ball. But I think decent batting track, ball was coming nicely onto the bat, as it was throughout the duration of the match. I think Chennai might have bargained for the fact that it was a fresh pitch, it was unused before this in the tournament, and they might have hoped for some kind of assistance because there was a little bit of grass cover and they could have expected a little bit of seam for the quicker bowlers, but there was no assistance at all. Chennai got off to a brilliant start with the fantastic run out by Duplessis to get to the fastest in the first over, but after that everything just went south. Rohit Sharma came in and played a brilliant innings. I mean, he's been not among the runs in the last 7-8 games, and for him to come and just turn it on was brilliant. But Chennai's bowling was, to be honest, quite ordinary. Too many short balls, too many full tosses. The fielding was slightly iffy. The intensity didn't appear as if it was there. And some of it has to do with the kind of strokes that Kartik and Simmons played at the top. Rohit and Simmons played at the top of the innings. Definitely not a 200 surface, if there is any such thing as so many number of runs surface. Maybe 175, 180 would have been more par for the course, but Mumbai batted beautifully and Chennai bowled quite poorly. Yeah, it was a strange sort of season. Usually you look at the IPL seasons over the years and Chennai stands out as one of the most dominant sides in any edition. This time around, Chennai were not even close to, I would say, 80% of their total potential. They had Raina didn't really fire on all cylinders. Bravo was quite ordinary with the bat, even though he finished as a leading wicket taker. Jadeja was largely absent both with the bat and with the ball. And once they lost McCullum to international duty, and once Dwayne Smith sort of fell off after the early promise that he had shown, Chennai were always behind the 8-ball, I think it didn't help them that they played 7 matches at home. In terms of the fact that the Chennai pitch has not really been conducive to stroke making, and Chennai is a side full of stroke makers, so they struggled to adapt to Chennai, they struggled to put up big scores, and then when they went outside, I think probably they were a little too over keen to make good use of the batting conditions. So as a batting unit, they never got going the whole season. And they were always looking for the bowlers to bail them out, which they did for the majority of the time. But it's very difficult for bowlers to keep bailing the team out match after match. The final was a sort of an aberration on the bowling unit because the bowling unit has been very good throughout the season. But aura around Chennai is sort of slowly dissipating. I think they still are one of the most consistent teams in the IPL. They've been in 6 finals, they won 2 titles. But the gap is closing, if it is already not closed. And I don't think Chennai will probably have to relook at strategy, look at personnel going forward. They're a proud side. They're not happy with just finishing second best. So it's been a while since they won the IPL title. So I think there will be some serious soul searching in the off-season. As for Mumbai, I mean, you look at the Mumbai squad, and even if you take out the fact that Hardik Pandya and Suchit sort of burst through, even if you take them away, you will still look at the quality in that Mumbai nine, and you will feel that this is a side that that can go all the way. It's the kind of side that is so dangerous that there's so much firepower in the batting, there's so much quality in the bowling with Malinga and Nathan and Harbhajan. The fact that somebody like Pradyan Oja hardly got a game, this shows the depth of their side. And they started poorly because they were a little hesitant, they lost a couple of close games. But once they got cornered enough, they realized that they had to win every game to make it to the playoffs. They were a completely different unit. Obviously, Ricky Ponting's experience at the international level helped them in his new coaching role. Rohit has shown that he enjoys captaincy in this format, at this level. So as a team, they were always probably a win or two away from turning things around, and that's exactly what happened after they had won just one of the first six games.